फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट वन, योर गिटहब अकाउंट, ईमेल अकाउंट, ईमेल आईडी, योर गिटहब अकाउंट ईमेल आईडी यू शुड सेंड टू मी, देन आई विल बी इनवाइटिंग टू क्लोन वन रिपॉजिटरी. फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट वन, सेंड योर ईमेल अकाउंट ईमेल आईडी whichever is used for GitHub account. While creating GitHub account, whatever email ID you have chosen, that email ID send it to me, then I will be sending an invitation to access Git repository. Now you will be getting a mail. Just open that mail, accept the invitation. Please accept. Accepting invitation. Just to accept the invitation, then open into GitHub. Once you open into the GitHub, you will be seeing this type of screen. This is the repository which I am sharing to you. This repository can be cloned through this URL. Click on code, HTTPS, then select this, copy it. By using this URL, we can able to clone. In order to clone any repository into our local system, we require one more software. That software is not installed yet. Please observe. There is one more software. Git-scm.com. This software is used only for cloning GitHub repositories to our local system. Git-scm.com. Git-scm.com. It is used for connecting GitHub account from the local system. It can be cloning or it can be pushing any kind of operations from the local system to the GitHub. We required scm.com. Everybody go to the git-scm.com. You can see right side a download for Windows. Click on this. It is downloading. You can choose any location. Once downloading is got over, just double click on it. Installation will be started. Keep going, next. Keep going, next. No need of bothering anything. It's already available in my system. I'm just to cancel. Now, once installation got over, you can create any one development directory. Guys, everybody, any one development directory. I'm just creating SFCC August. Let me go for 22nd. Any folder name without any spaces. Any folder name without any spaces. Try cloning complete repository into this folder. try cloning complete repository into this folder. Right click and select Git Bash here. Are you able to see? Right click and Git Bash here. Are you getting this type of window? Right click Git Bash here. Now you have to use Git space, clone space, whatever URL you copied. Whatever URL you copied. Press enter. It will ask username and password here. If it is asking username and password, try entering username and password through a browser login. You will be getting one small pop-up window. Just to check it out, that pop-up window, and enter your GitHub username and password. GitHub username and password. Now you can see. Are you getting SFCC August latest?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now you got a base code. Inside this base code, you need to develop dw.json. dw.json, and then you can open this one. Please upset. Open the VS Code from this. You can open the VS Code from this location, from the repository. This is the repository you cloned. Open a VS Code. First to type cmd, everybody. In the cmd you can specify code space dot. Allow. Now in this folder, in the SFCC August, in this folder, you need to develop dw.json. You can click new file. New file, you can see dw.json. Inside this file, you need to provide you need to provide your login credentials. We have already seen host name, something, username, specify your email account, password, specify whatever password you specify. You can specify any password. Then you need to specify code version, any version of the code, version 1 or version 2, you can choose with your name also. So you don't have a sandbox access. From now onwards, just to develop, you are not able to test it. I will show you the procedure completely. Generally, this is a sandbox URL. In this sandbox URL, you have to remove these first few characters. https://2/ should be removed. Then, till to salesforce.com you have to consider. The remaining things you should remove. Your sandbox login itself, that URL itself containing what is your host name. I mentioned the host name as this one. I will be providing sandbox logins maybe another 1 week. At that time, you will be getting a URL. Till that, you can just observe, and I will be giving my login credentials itself to practice. ramesh@lara.co.in. Please note down my URL, username, password. This only you will be using for a few days. Most probably for 1 week you have to use this one. You can mention any code version, whichever is available. Maybe I can create one code version today, like Saturday. Version name I'm mentioning like a Saturday V1, assume. This we will be creating. Now, let us configure something in the server side. Opening into sandbox, everybody. Hey. I'm very sorry, guys. Today, sandbox is not up. Generally, they are given in the weekends also. So today, no problem. I'll just show the process. That's all. You cannot do anything now. Now, everybody, expand site genesis, you can see two important folders. One is controllers, second one is a core. First two folder names you can note down. We will be developing everything in the first two folders only. So please observe, storefront controllers, storefront core. These two folders are having cartridges as well. Cartridges is nothing but source folder. You can see controllers expand cartridges there, and the core expand cartridges there. Controllers cartridge, core also cartridge. Inside a controllers, open the cartridge. Inside a cartridge, there are different types of sources. One is controllers, second one is scripts, third one is templates, likewise. Expand controllers. Expand controllers. Right click on controllers. Go to the new file. Right click on controllers. Go to new file. I am choosing test.js. T should be in the uppercase. Test.js. Here you can develop a one function. This already we have seen. I'll just develop some sample code rather than developing right from the scratch. Definitely you may have this code. Same code you can use. I thought of like showing one more time, but very unfortunately it's not working. We can have a practice of developing at least one controller. Just one. So let us give a, instead of sample one, we can go for test one. Only for practice purpose, today we cannot do anything. It's a simple. Two variables we are declaring to specifying app and got. Function test one, then test one. See, this test one should be supplied here. Come on. Now go to the view development. It's a template. This should be developed in the second folder. Come on, guys. Expand app storefront core. Cartridge. Templates. Default. Right click on default. Go to the new folder. Specify Hello as a folder name. Okay. Hello folder already available. No problem. In my system, Hello folder is already available. Go inside a Hello folder. Try defining test view. Right click on test. Go to the new file. Choose the file name as test view. You can go for any Hello one. It's a simple development. We cannot test it, but you should use the URL as test-test1. Test is a JS file. Test1 is a export URL name. This can be accessed through test-test1. That portion, anyhow, we cannot test it now.